Hello everyone, I'm Priyanka Shine. Welcome to my YouTube channel Mathalite. In this video, we'll start with exercise 3B from chapter Compound Interest Using Formula. So starting with question number 1, the difference between simple interest and compound interest on a certain sum is ₹54.40 for 2 years at 8% per annum. Find the sum. We have to find the sum, that is the principal. Okay, the sum of money that you invest is nothing but principal. So we have to find principal. Now the difference between simple interest and compound interest on a certain sum is 54.40. Difference between simple interest and compound interest, these two interest, is this much rupees. Okay, this is the difference in rupees between these two interest. Now for 2 years at 8% per annum, if you notice, we are given one time period. Okay, that is the number of years, is one value only is given to us. Also rate of interest, only one value is given to us. Even the sum, okay, is same for both simple interest and compound interest, because we are given only one values. So the principal, let it be x rupees, the number of years or time period, and the rate of interest is same for simple interest also and for compound interest also. Okay, so if you calculate these two, so you are going to substitute the same values for both the interest. Okay, now the important part is you are given the difference between simple interest and compound interest. So simple interest minus compound interest is equal to ₹54.40. some of you might take it like this, it's wrong. What you have to do is take CI minus SI. CI will be greater than SI, not SI greater than CI. Why? Because you're investing same sum of money, same time period hai, and same rate of interest hai for both these. So whenever for both the interest, you are given same sum, same number of years, same rate of interest, then obviously compound interest will be greater than simple interest. Please keep this in mind. Okay, so jabhi bhi same values diya hai for both the interest, then obviously CI will be greater than SI, because in simple interest you get interest only on principal, in compound interest you get interest in both, for both principal as well as previous years ka interest. Okay, so interest में भी interest मिलता है. So compound interest is always greater than simple interest. So take CI minus SI is equal to this. Now it's easy to find CI and SI. For SI, the formula is P into R into T upon 100. P is X rupees, we'll assume it to be X rupees. R we know, T we know. So you can substitute and find, you'll get some value in terms of X. Okay, X he sirf unknown है, बाकी all values we know. Now similarly you will calculate CI. CI is what? A minus B. A is nothing but P into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to N. Okay, minus P. So this is amount ka formula minus principal. Now over here also we know P is X, R is 8%, and N is 2 years. So you can substitute the values and again you will get CI in terms of X. Okay, so CI something milega, SI something milega, substitute the values and you will get the value of X. X is nothing but the principal, the sum of money that we have to find. Okay, so now let us write down the given information and start solving. Now we have to find the sum, that is principal. So we'll assume it to be X rupees. Okay, so let the sum, that is principal, be X rupees. Okay, now we need to find simple interest and compound interest, okay, in terms of X, because we know that compound interest minus simple interest is equal to 54.40 rupees. Okay, so we'll find CI, we'll find SI, then substitute the values in this condition. Okay, so first I'll find CI. So for CI, what is principal, number of years and rate of interest? Principal is X rupees, number of years is 2 years, and rate of interest is 8% per annum. Okay, so using the formula, CI is A minus P. A is P into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to N minus P. Okay. So, P is X and R is 8. N is 2. So, 4 2s are 425s are. So, we get X into 1 plus 2 upon 25 raised to 2 minus X. Over here, we'll equalize the denominator, so we'll multiply by 25 in both numerator and denominator. Okay, basically we are taking LCM. So 25 upon 25 plus 2 upon 25 raised to 2 minus X. Okay, so CI is equal to X into 25 plus 2 upon 25 raised to 2 minus X. So we get X into 27 upon 25 squared minus X. Now 27 square is 729 and this is 625. Okay. So we get 729X upon 625 minus X. Over here again we'll take LCM, we'll multiply by 625 both numerator and denominator. Okay, so we get 729x upon 625 minus 625x upon 625. Okay, so equal denominators hai, so we can take common denominator 729x minus 625x. Okay, so CI is equal to 729x minus 625x, that will give you 104x upon 625 rupees. This is simplified now. So we found the value of compound interest in terms of x. Okay, now let it be as it is. Now we'll find simple interest. Okay, so simple interest, again the principal, rate of interest and time period is same for the simple interest also. Principal is X rupees, rate of interest is 8% per annum and time period is 2 years. So let us find simple interest. So for simple interest, principal is X rupees, rate of interest is 8% per annum and time period is 2 years. Okay. Now, simple interest is P into R into T upon 100. Okay, so X into 8 into 2 upon 100. So we get 4 2s are 425s are, 2 2s are 4 into X. So 4X upon 25 rupees. We found compound interest, we found simple interest. Now we'll use the condition, the difference of compound interest and simple interest. It is 54.40 rupees. Okay. So for same principal, rate of interest and time period, whenever these three values are same, compound interest is greater than simple interest. So CI is greater than SI. Okay. So therefore I'll take CI minus SI equal to 54.40 rupees, not SI minus CI. Okay. So now substituting the values, this we got as 104x upon 625. This we got as 4x upon 25. Is equal to 54.40, so I can write it as 5440 upon 100. Okay, basically we are multiplying by 100 in both numerator and denominator to remove decimal point. Okay, now over here we'll take LCM, we'll multiply by 25 in both numerator and denominator. 25 into 25 we have 625, denominators equal karte hain. So 104x upon 625 minus 25 into 4x upon 25 into 25 is equal to 544 upon 10. Okay, 00 gets cancelled. So we get 104x minus 100x upon 625. Okay, सेम डिनोमिनेटर है. सो 5 4 4 upon 10. सो वी गेट 4x upon 625 = 5 4 4 upon 10. ओके, शिफ्टिंग द नंबर्स ऑन द अदर साइड. सो 5 4 4 upon 10 into 625 upon 4. सो 4 1s are 4. सो 1 remains 4 3s are 12. 2 remains. सो 24 4 6s are 24. ओके, सो वी गेट 136 into 625 upon 10. सो वी गेट 85,000 upon 10, विच इज 8,500 rupees. सो वी फाउंड द प्रिंसिपल दैट इज सम. सो जस्ट राइट डाउन द फाइनल स्टेटमेंट. देयरफॉर द सम इज ₹8,500. डोंट फॉरगेट टू पुट रुपी का सिंबल. ओके, कमिंग टू नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. अ सम ऑफ मनी इन्वेस्टेड एट कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट अमाउंट्स टू ₹19,360 इन 2 years एंड ₹23,425.60 इन 4 years. फाइंड द रेट परसेंट एंड द ओरिजिनल सम ऑफ मनी. We have to find rate percent, that is R, and the original sum of money, that is principal P. Okay, so there are 2 quantities to be found over here. One is principal and another one is R. Okay, so over here we are given 2 amounts. All right, if you read the question carefully, a sum of money invested at compound interest amounts to ₹19,360 in 2 years. This is the amount in 2 years and ₹23,425.60 in 4 years. This is the amount in 4 years. So there are 2 amounts, one after 2 years and the other one after 4 years. Okay, so let us write that down. Amount in 2 years is ₹19,360 and another one is amount in 4 years. That is ₹23,425.60. Okay. Now, since we are given amounts, what are we going to do? We'll use the formula of amount. What is amount? It is P into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to N. So, now, for this condition, we know that amount is this much. So, we'll substitute the value of amount. P will remain as it is, R will remain as it is, N will be 2 because this is the amount after 2 years, amount after 2 years, so N will be 2 in this case. Now this one also we will solve separately using the same formula. Amount we know, so we will substitute the value. P and R will remain as it is. N will be 4 in this case. 4 years ke baad ka amount hai. So this is 4. So we'll solve this separately, okay? And we'll equate these two afterwards, okay? So first, let us consider amount in 2 years and start solving, okay? So for the first case, number of years is 2 years, okay? So, after 2 years, amount is 19,360, okay, and number of years is 2 years. Principal and rate of interest we have to find. So, we'll keep that as it is. Using the formula raised to N, okay. Now amount is 19,360, it is equal to P into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to N, that is 2. Okay, now over here let us solve this. Okay, why? Because what we are going to do is we are going to shift this bracket on the other side. Okay, so it will go in denominator. Yahan pe into hai. Okay, so when it goes on the other side, it will go in denominator, divide ho jayega. So it will become 19360 अपॉन 1 प्लस आर अपॉन 100 द होल थिंग का स्क्वायर. ओके, सो यू कैन सॉल्व एंड शिफ्ट इट ऑन द अदर साइड और शिफ्ट द एंटायर थिंग ऑन द अदर साइड. ओके, यू कैन डू इट दैट वे ऑल्सो. सो लेट अस नॉट सॉल्व, लेट अस शिफ्ट इट ऑन द अदर साइड डायरेक्टली. ओके, सो दिस पार्ट शुड गो करेक्ट. ओके, वेन यू शिफ्ट दिस, ये डिनोमिनेटर में चला जाएगा. सो आई कैन गेट पी इज इक्वल टू दिस थिंग, प्रिंसिपल इज इक्वल टू दिस थिंग. ऑल राइट, मार्क दिस एज वन. ऑल राइट, नाउ वील कंसिडर द अमाउंट आफ्टर 4 years. ऑल राइट, वील यूज द सेम मेथड फॉर दैट. So after 4 years, amount is 23425.60 rupees and n is 4 years. All right, p and r will remain same. So using the formula, a is equal to p into 1 plus r upon 100 raised to n. A is 23425.60 is equal to P into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to 4. N is 4 over here. Now there is decimal point. So what we'll do, we'll remove the decimal point. So this will become 23425.60 upon 100. Okay, basically we multiplied by 100 in both numerator and denominator. Okay, so yahan pe decimal vanish ho gaya and there is 1 into 100, that is 100 in denominator. So we get P into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to 4. Now we'll shift this on the other side. Same thing that we did in amount after 2 years, okay? So here there is into sign. When we shift this on the other side, it will go in denominator. So it will become 23425.60 upon 100 into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to 4 is equal to P. Okay, mark this as 2. Now we are getting P equal to this, and for the first equation we are getting P equal to something else. Now we know that principle is going to remain same. P to same value hi hai, the amount, the sum of money that you invest, that is going to remain same. So P is equal to this also, P is equal to that also. That means RHS RHS equal hai, to LHS LHS bhi equal hoga. Okay, if I say A is equal to B and C is equal to B, both are equal to B, that means A is equal to C. RHS RHS is equal, to LHS LHS will be equal. So I can say A is equal to C. So same thing over here, this will be equal to the first part that we got. Okay, so this LHS is equal to the LHS of the first equation. Now from 1 and 2, we know principal is equal to something in equation 1 and principal is equal to something in equation 2. Now we know that principal is same. Okay, so LHS LHS will be equal. Okay, so LHS of equation 1 will be equal to LHS of equation 2. So we'll get LHS of equation 1 was 19360 upon 1 plus R upon 100 raised to 2, and LHS of equation 2 was 23425.60 upon 100 into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to 4. Now what we'll do is first cross multiply. Okay, first just cross multiply. So 19360 into ho jayega. Okay, this will get multiplied into 100 into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to 4 is equal to 23425.60 into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to 2. Okay, now what we'll do is bring the numbers together and these two brackets together. Okay, these two brackets are same if you notice, 1 plus R upon 100, 1 plus R upon 100. So what we'll do is shift this over here. Okay, so this will go in denominator. Same thing, shift the numbers over here. So these will go in denominator. So 1 plus R upon 100 raised to 4 upon 1 plus r upon 100 raised to 2 is equal to 234,2560. We'll shift this, so it will go in denominator, 19,360 into 100. Okay, 0,0 gets cancelled. Now, if you notice, the bases are same. Okay, 1 plus r upon 100, 1 plus r upon 100. Raised to 4, raised to 2. This is like x raised to 4 upon x square. So, what will you do? We know this will be x into x into x into x. And this is x into x. So, basically, we'll get x square. Same thing over here. Alright. So, when we cancel out, what will we be left with? So, 1 plus r upon 100 raised to 2, we'll be left with this. This is like x raised to 4 upon x raised to 2. So, we'll be left with x square over here. Theek hai? Cancel out ho jayega. So, here we need to solve now. This is 234,2560 upon 19,360. Okay. So, let us solve this now. Alright. Now, here there is square, so try to bring squares over here. You should get squares over here in RHS. Okay, so LHS and RHS both will be in square form. Once you get it in square form, you can take square root on both the sides. Okay, so let us cancel this out. Okay, so jo bhi cancel ho raha hai, try to cancel it out. 2 9s are 18, 2 6s are 12, 2 8s are 16, 0, 0. 2 1s are, 2 1s are, 2 7s are, 2 1s are, 2 2s are, and 2 8s are. Okay. So 2 4s are, 2 8s are, 2 4s are, 0 0. 2 5s are 10. Okay. And 2 8s are 16. 2 5s are 10. 2 6s are 12, 2 4s are. We can still cancel out 2 2s are, 2 4s are, 2s are 0 0. 2 2s are 4, 2 9s are 18. 2 2s are 4, 2 8s are 16, 2 2s are. Okay. 2 1s are, 2s are, 1s are 0 0. Over here we'll be left with 2 1s are, 2 4s are, 2 6s are, 2 4s are, 2 1s are. So we are left with 1 4 6 4 1 upon 1 2 1 0 0 is equal to 1 plus r upon 100 raised to 2. Okay. Now let us check these numbers. You can factorize and check. Okay. 121. Forget the zeros. 121 is 11 ka square. Okay. So, ye 11 ka square ho jayega. Basically, this is 11 into 11 into 10 into 10. Okay. And over here, we need to find 14641. 14641 ko we can factorize and find. Okay. So, if we factorize 1, 4, 6, 4, 1, let us try this by 11 only. 11, 1's are 11, so 3 remains, okay. So, 11, 3's are 33, again 3 remains, okay. 11, 3's are 33 and 1 remains, so 11, 1's are. 11, 1's are again, so 2 remains 23, 11, 2's are 22 and 11, 1's are. 11, 11s are 11, 1s are. So here we are getting 11 into 11 into 11 into 11. So I can cancel out these 11s and we are left with 11 square upon 10 square. Okay. So we are getting 1 plus r upon 100. The whole thing ka square is equal to 11 square upon 10 square. Now we can take square root on both the sides. Okay, so we'll get 1 plus r upon 100 is equal to 11 upon 10. So 1 plus r upon 100, the whole thing ka square is equal to 11 upon 10 is ka square. Now we got this. Okay, so we'll take square root on both the sides. Taking square root on both the sides. So we'll get 1 plus r upon 100 is equal to 11 upon 10. Now it's simplified, okay? Shift 1. So r upon 100 is equal to 11 upon 10 minus 1. So r is equal to 11 upon 10 minus 10 upon 10. Sorry, upon 100. Is equal to 11 minus 10 upon 10. So r upon 100 is equal to 1 upon 10. So we get r is equal to 1 into 100 upon 10. So r is equal to 1 into 10, that is 10%. So we found the rate of interest, that is 10%. Okay. So r mil gaya. Now we need to find the principal, that is the sum of money. So use either equation 1 or 2 to find principal. Okay. Now to find principal, that is sum of money, you can use equation 1 or 2. Okay, that would be easier way to solve. So let us use equation 1. Okay, I'll be using equation 1. You can also use equation 2. So from 1, what do we know? We know that principal is equal to 19360 upon 1 plus r upon 100 raised to 2. Now substitute the value of r, it is 10%. So 19360 upon 1 plus 10 upon 100 raised to 2. 0, 0 gets cancelled. So we get 19360 upon 1 plus 1 upon 10 raised to 2. Now we'll equalize the denominators in brackets. Okay. So we get 19360 upon 10 upon 10 plus 1 upon 10 raised to 2. So we get 19360. Okay, 10 plus 1 upon 10. So principal is equal to 19360 upon 11 upon 10 ka square. Now whenever you have denominator in denominator, it goes in numerator. Okay, so now you can shift. Now the bracket is solved. Okay, there is no plus or minus sign in between. Here we had plus sign, so you cannot take this in numerator. Okay, so please don't do that mistake. Now the bracket is solved, so now you can shift this. Okay, so please be very, very careful. 19360, this will go in numerator. Okay, so basically, if this is confusing for you, how you can consider 19360 divided by 11 upon 10 ka square hai, divided by hai. Okay, so what you do whenever there is division, you take multiplication, toh reciprocal ho jayega. This will go in numerator, so 10 upon 11 ka square. Okay, so this is easier way to remember. What you can do is 19360 divided by this, keep solving. Ultimately, when the bracket is solved, now you can take reciprocal. So convert this into multiplication and then take reciprocal into 10 into 10 upon 11 into 11. Okay, so 11 ones are 11, 8 remains. Okay, 11 sevens are 77, 6 remains. So 11 6 are 66 and 0. Again 11 ones are and 6 remains, 11 6 are and 0. So 160 into 100, that is 16,000 is the principal. So we found principal and rate of interest. Box these two answers, write down the final statement. The rate of interest R is 10% and the principal, that is the sum of money, is rupees 16,000. Don't forget the symbol of rupees. Let's read the next question. Question number 3. A sum of money lent out at CI at a certain rate per annum becomes 3 times of itself in 8 years. Find in how many years will the money become 27 times of itself at the same rate of interest per annum. There is sum of money. Okay, that is principal. Now what is the sum of money that is principal? We are not given. So we'll assume it to be X rupees. Okay, so let's say there is some sum of money, rupees X. Okay, a sum of money is lent out at CI at certain rate per annum. So the money is being compounded, okay, at certain rate per annum. Now again, what is the rate of interest? We are not given. ओके सो लेट द रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट आर बी कैपिटल आर, ओके लेट इट बी आर परसेंट, बिकम्स 3 times ऑफ इट सेल्फ इन 8 years. So you are investing some amount of money, some sum of money, and it becomes 3 times of itself in 8 years. You invest some money and you get the money after certain period of years, after certain time. Then what is that money called? It is amount. Okay. So the amount after 8 years is nothing but 3 times of the principal. Okay. So the money becomes 3 times of itself in 8 years. That is nothing but amount in 8 years. Okay. So amount in 8 years is 3 times of itself. That is 3 times of the principal. Okay. Sum of money becomes 3 times of itself. 3 times of itself. Sum of money kitna x hai. So 3 times of itself matlab 3 times x. So 3 into x, that is 3x rupees. So amount in 8 years is rupees 3x. Alright. Find in how many years will the money become 27 times of itself at the same rate of interest per annum. For now, forget this part. Okay. Focus on this part. Amount in 8 years is given to you. Okay. Now, amount in 8 years is given. So let us use the formula of amount. Okay, so for that we'll use the formula A is equal to P into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to N. Alright, now amount is what? It is 3 times X, so it is 3X. Principal is X. Alright, R is capital R. Alright, upon 100, and N will be what? N will be 8 years. Okay. Jitne years ke baad hum log find out kar rahe amount, that will be the number of years. So over here amount after 8 years is given. So it will be 8 years. Okay. Now if you solve this, you can shift x over here. So you will get 3x upon x is equal to 1 plus r upon 100 raised to 8. So we get 3 is equal to 1 plus R upon 100 raised to 8. So from this, we'll get this. From amount in 8 years, we'll get this information. Okay. So let us keep this aside for now. Now we'll focus on the other part of the question. Okay. So we got this. Let us write this down. So it is 3 is equal to 1 plus R upon 100 raised to 8. Okay. Now coming to the second part of the question. Find in how many years will the money become 27 times of itself at the same rate of interest per annum. Now you are investing the same sum of money. Okay. So find in how many years will the money, that is the same sum of money, principal is X rupees. And it will become 27 times of itself at the same rate of interest per annum. So R is also same. P and R is same. Now the money will become 27 times of itself. That is the amount. Okay. So amount will be 27 times of the sum of money. Okay. 27 times of itself. Money will become 27 times of itself. So money was X rupees. So it will become 27 times of itself. That is 27 into X rupees. Okay. Find in how many years. That is number of years. We don't know. We have to find. So we don't know principal. We don't know rate of interest. And over here we need to find the number of years. Let us assume the number of years to be capital N years. Okay, so let's say this is the amount after N years. Okay, so again we'll use the formula over here. Okay, so A is equal to P into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to N. Okay, now amount is 27x. So 27x is equal to principal is x. 1 plus r is r upon 100 and n is capital N over here. All right. Now again we shift x. So 27x upon x is equal to 1 plus r upon 100 raised to n. So x gets cancelled and we are left with 27 is equal to 1 plus r upon 100 raised to n. Now this is what we have from both the conditions. Can we relate LHS, LHS or RHS, RHS? No. Because LHS mein yahan pe 27 hai, yahan pe 3 hai. RHS mein yahan pe 1 plus r upon 100 raised to 8 and yahan pe we have 1 plus r upon 100 raised to n. Now, what if I remove these powers? Okay, what if I make this 1 plus r upon 100 and this also 1 plus r upon 100, then RHS, RHS will be equal. Okay, so if RHS, RHS will be equal, I can relate LHS, LHS. Okay, so how will I make RHS, RHS equal in this case? Okay, I want to remove this power. 8 ko nikal dete hai and yaha pe n nikal dena hai. How will you remove these powers? Now, whenever you have square, you take square root. You have cube, you take cube root. So over here, we have raised to 8, we'll take 8th root. Okay, so whatever power is there, uska root lena hai. Okay, so here we have raised to 8, so we'll take 8th root. Alright, so 8th root is basically what? It will be 1 by 8. Okay, square root means 1 by 2 ho jata hai. Okay, so square root is nothing but 1 by 2. Power, I'm talking about power. Okay, so square root is raised to 1 by 2. Okay, so if you have x square, okay, and you take square root, so it is x square raised to 1 by 2. Alright, so 2 into 1 upon 2 will give 1. So power kya ho jata hai? 1 ho jata hai. If you have cube, you take cube root and it becomes x raised to 1. 3 into 1 by 3, that is 3, 3 gets cancelled and you get x raised to 1. Same thing, here we have something raised to 8. So we'll take 8th root. So 8th root is nothing but 1 by 8. Power will be raised to 1 by 8. So over here, alright, we'll take 8th root. So taking 8th root on both the sides, what will we get? 3 raised to 1 by 8 is equal to 1 plus r upon 100 raised to 8 raised to 1 by 8. So over here the power will vanish. That is basically 8 into 1 by 8, that will become 1 raised to 1 ho jayega. So we'll get 1 plus r upon 100 raised to 1. That is nothing but 1 plus r upon 100 is equal to 3 raised to 1 by 8. Okay, now same thing we'll do over here. We don't want n, so what will we do over here? We'll take nth root. Okay, so raised to 1 by n. So if you take nth root, this will become raised to 1 by n and this raised to 1 by n. So n into 1 by n becomes 1. Okay, that is 1 plus r upon 100. All right. So we'll get 1 plus r upon 100 is equal to 27 raised to 1 by n. Now the RHS is equal, so I can relate LHS. RHS, RHS is equal, so LHS, LHS will be equal. So I can say 3 raised to 1 by 8 is equal to 27 raised to 1 by n. Okay. So when you are solving for the amount for 8 years, you need to take the root, and same thing for n years, you need to take the nth root. Okay. Now once you get RHS equal, LHS, LHS relate kar payenge. So 3 raised to 1 by 8 will be equal to 27 raised to 1 by n. Okay. So RHS, RHS equal hai, to LHS, LHS equal hoga. Now over here, are the bases equal? No. Are the powers equal? No. Now what I need to do is make either of the two equal. So what I'll do is, yahan pe 3 hai, yahan pe 27 hai. 27 I can write in terms of 3. Alright, 27 is what? It is 3 cube. 3 into 3 into 3 gives you 27. Okay, so 27 I can write as 3 cube. So it is 3 cube raised to 1 by n. Now, the powers, something raised to something, I can multiply the powers by law of indices. So 3 raised to 3 raised to 1 by n, I can write it as 3 into 1 by n. Correct. So it is 3 into 1 gives 3 upon n. Okay. So 3 raised to 3 by n is equal to 3 raised to 1 by 8. Now the bases are equal. So the powers should be equal. You have something equal to something and the bases are equal, so powers should be equal. Okay. So 1 by 8 is equal to 3 by n. Okay. If you are given x raised to a is equal to x raised to b, okay. X to equal hai, to A should be equal to B. Okay, this is law of indices. So we are using that only over here. So the powers will be equal. Now it's easy, just cross multiply and you will get 1 into n, that is n is equal to 3 into 8, that is 24. So number of years is 24 years. So after 24 years, the money will become 27 times of itself. So this sum is little tricky, but you have to use the conditions accordingly and solve, so it will become easy. Okay, so now we'll use proper statements and start solving. Now, before you start with the solution, always write down the given information. Okay, now over here we are not given the principal and rate of interest, so we'll assume them to be something. So we are assuming principal to be rupees x and the rate of interest r is r percent per annum, that is capital R. Okay. Now, we are given two conditions over here. The money becomes 3 times of itself in 8 years. So, the money that you get after a certain period is nothing but amount. Okay, so the amount is 3 times the principal. So, amount will be rupees 3 into x, that is 3x. Okay, 3 times the principal. Alright, principal is x rupees. Now, in how many years will the money become 27 times of itself? So, the amount after certain period, okay, that is n years, we have taken n to be capital N in this case because we don't know the number of years. So, it is after n years, we are getting 27 times the principal, that is 27x. Okay, now we'll be using these two given information, okay, that is we'll use the formula of amount and solve. Okay, so now let us start solving. First we'll consider n equal to 8 years. We know p, we know r, we know n. We'll substitute the values and solve for the amount. Okay, so after 8 years, now principal is x rupees, amount is 3 times the principal. Okay, and rate of interest is r percent per annum. All right, and n is 8 years. Okay, after 8 years, so obviously n will be 8 years. Now using the formula, a is equal to p into 1 plus r upon 100 raised to n. A is 3x, p is x, 1 plus r is capital R upon 100 raised to n is 8 years. Okay. Now we'll shift x over here also, you can cancel out. Okay. Something into x and something into x. So x, x cancel ho jayega. Or better way, shift it and then cancel it. Now we get 3 is equal to 1 plus r upon 100 raised to 8. Do we want this? No. We want to remove the power. So whenever there is a power, what do we do? We take root. Okay. So square hota hai to square root. Yahan pe 8 hai to 8th root. So taking 8th root on both the sides. रूट मतलब क्या हो जाएगा, वन अपॉन समथिंग. ओके, सो इफ यू हैव स्क्वायर रूट वन अपॉन टू, इफ यू हैव क्यूब रूट वन अपॉन थ्री. ओके, सो द पावर विल बी दैट. ओवर हियर देयर इज एट रूट, सो वन अपॉन एट हो जाएगा, द पावर ऑफ थ्री विल बी वन अपॉन एट. ओके, नाउ यहाँ पे वील गेट वन प्लस आर अपॉन हंड्रेड रेज टू एट रेज टू वन अपॉन एट. ओके, now we multiply the powers, so 8 into 1 upon 8 is nothing but 1. Okay, so the power will go away. Okay, that was our aim. So we get 3 raised to 1 upon 8 is equal to 1 plus r upon 100 raised to 1. That is, if I don't write 1, it's okay. X raised to 1 is nothing but x. Okay, so same thing over here. Now we wanted this. Okay, so mark this as 1. All right, now we'll move on to the second condition. In second condition, we don't know the number of years, it will be n years. Okay, so principle will remain same, amount and number of years is going to change. Okay, so after capital N years, principle is the same. Okay, same amount of money you're investing. Now, amount becomes 27 times of the principal and N will be capital N years. Now, we'll use a formula of amount and start solving. Okay, now this is the formula. We'll just substitute the values. Okay, so A is 27x, P is x. 1 plus R is capital R upon 100 and N is N years, capital N. Okay, shifting X, so 27X upon X is equal to 1 plus R upon 100 raised to N. X gets cancelled, so we are left with 27 is equal to 1 plus R upon 100 raised to N. Now, do we want the power? No. So what we'll do? We'll take root. Okay, so if there is square, we take square root. Cube, we take cube root. Yahan pe n hai, so nth root. So taking nth root on both the sides, what will we get? When you take root, it becomes raised to 1 upon that power. Okay, so square root hoga to 1 upon 2. If it is cube root, raised to 1 upon 3. So here it is nth root, so raised to 1 upon n. Okay, is equal to 1 plus r upon 100 raised to n raised to 1 upon n. Correct. Dono side pe raised to 1 upon n ho jayega. Now, yahan pe the powers will get multiplied n into 1 upon n. n gets cancelled and we are left with 1. Okay. So, that is basically 1 plus r upon 100. So, we get 27 raised to 1 upon n is equal to 1 plus r upon 100. Okay. Now, we have RHS, RHS equal. This was equation 1. Okay. This is 2. From 1 and 2, we can say RHS is equal. So, from 1 and 2, RHS is equal. So, LHS will be equal. So, this is equal to this. Okay. So, I can say 3 raised to 1 upon 8 is equal to 27 raised to 1 upon n. Okay. Now, over here, we are given something is equal to something. But are the powers or are the bases equal? No. We need to make them equal. Something should be equal. So we can make the bases equal. Okay, bases ko equal kar sakte hai. Now, here we have 3. We cannot bring it in terms of 27. Instead, what we'll do is, we'll write 27 in terms of 3. Okay, so what is 27? It is 3 cube. Okay, you can factorize. 3 9s are, 3 3s are, 3 1s are. So 3 into 3 into 3, that is 3 cube. So we get 3 cube raised to 1 upon n. Be very, very careful. Okay. Now, the power, something 3 raised to 3 raised to 1 upon n. So, we can multiply the powers. Okay. So, 3 into 1 upon n ho jayega. Okay. Law of indices. You should be thorough with law of indices, students. So, 3 raised to 3 into 1 upon n ho jayega. 3 into 1 gives 3 upon n ho jayega. So, we get 3 raised to 1 upon 8 is equal to 3 raised to 3 upon n. Now, the bases are equal, so I can say powers are equal. Okay? We have x raised to something is equal to x raised to something. Bases is equal. Okay? यही इक्वल है तो ये ऑटोमेटिकली शुड बी इक्वल सो दिस विल बी इक्वल सो 1 अपॉन 8 इज इक्वल टू 3 अपॉन एन सो जस्ट राइट डाउन सिंस बेसिस आर इक्वल द पावर्स विल बी इक्वल ओके नाउ इट्स इजी क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई सो 1 इंटू एन गिव्स एन इज इक्वल टू 3 इंटू 8 दैट इज 24 So, n is equal to 24. Okay. So, we get 1 into n is equal to 3 into 8. So, n is equal to 24. All right. So, after 24 years, the money, that is the amount, will be 27 times of the principal. Okay. So, just write down the final statement, alright? And don't forget to put the unit. Yahan pe years hai. Okay? So, this is what we had to find.